50 games have been played, 116 goals have been scored in 5 cities and 6 venues in the Ivory Coast, where we are witnessing undoubtedly the greatest Africa Cup of Nations tournament of our lifetimes. My name is Tunde Young, John Ojetunde is here, and this is Prime Sports. We are going to be breaking down the Africa Cup of Nations. 50 games gone, 2 to go. The Super Eagles of Nigeria in the final, and Bafana, and DR Congo will be doing justice in the third place game. John, summarize all these two words.
amazing, super amazing. This is a tournament that not too many give expectation. I told you before the start of this tournament, too many pessimism in there. Mm-hmm. As regards preparation, as regards the chance of the Super Eagles. But then again, here we are. We are proud to say that we are Nigerians, because our own dear Super Eagles have done us proud.
They've definitely done us proud. Just in case you have been living under a rock, because even people in prison are away by now. In case you have been living under a rock, the Super Eagles of Nigeria defeated Angola in the quarterfinals and then went on to the semis to beat Bafana, South Africa on penalties. 1-1, it ended in regulation time. Yeah. And after extra time, we progressed to penalties. And 4-2, Nigeria emerged winners of that one to advance to the first Afcon final since 2013, and only our 8th Afcon final in history. John, how was the semi-final for you? Were you feeling confident before the semi-final? Did it go as you expected? Because it seemed like a pretty balanced game, but there are also people that believe that South Africa played better than Nigeria.
Yes, I think I'm also of that school of thought that the South Africans were better, especially in the first half. And why I said that, I saw that they employed these tactics of you know getting percentile behind our strikers. They know that our defenders are not the fastest of defenders. So what they did most times was to play the ball behind percentile, to get ahead of our defenders. And a couple of times we did that. We had a couple of chances.
Exploited our highlights.
Yes,
with long passes.
Exactly. And I remember twice, Sito, that's the defender of South Africa, gave that 2 long passes where, Ekong and Shimi Ajayi were found wanting. But at the end of the day, thanks must go to Stanley Wabali also, for keeping the shape and the confidence. Also, giving the team the desired morale, they needed, in that game.
From the Nigerian perspective, I actually don't think Nigeria played as badly as a lot of people did. Yes, the first half, South Africa had the upper hand.
They had more
position. But this is a game that not only had 2 halves, but had 30 extra minutes of extra time, mm-hmm. in which Nigeria dominated, in my opinion. Nigeria, both teams had 40 shots on goal, 7 shots on target each. Nigeria had 3 big chances, South Africa had 2 big chances. So from the second half, you have to give the team credit for the way they came out in the second half and set things right and started to beat South Africa's defense with passes of their own, although not long balls, but not over the top, but on the ground, playing the pass in behind and making Osimhen run, making Murphy run. That's how Nigeria got the free kick that led to the red card, mm-hmm. in the first place. So I have to give them credit for waking up. South Africa started well, but the Super Eagles, took their ascendancy back from them, and although they could not drive home their advantage within regulation time due to the interesting call, which was correct.
Yes,
penalty was right. But how do you go from 2-0 up, scoring and celebrating, to cancelling the goal and giving the penalty?
But that's the interesting thing about this Afcon. And I listened to, I don't know if you also listened to Gary Neville talking about the officiating tournament. Mm-hmm. He spoke glowingly, of the officiating, because of course we've had too many VAR issues in the Premier League, mm-hmm. and then for Gary Neville, he feels that they should come to Africa to come and learn how we use the VAR and how excellent it has been since the start of the Afcon. So these are part of the reasons why you described this Afcon as one of the greatest in our lifetime.
Yeah, absolutely. And so the referee situation, absolute shout out to the African referees, mm-hmm. who have officiated in all 50 games so far, and we hope that the officiating continues for the final 2 games without any controversy. But as for the English referees, I don't think there's a lot to learn. They are aware of the rules. It's just a case of stop being the main characters.
Exactly.
Judge every case on the situation by situation basis. Did this person follow the rules? Did he not? Is this right? Is this not right? That's all you literally need to be a referee. But English referees always want to hug their attention, and they have several influences on making their decision. They consider the reputation of the player involved, the team that they are playing for, and whatnot. And it just makes arriving at the right decision other than it needs to be. And that's the major difference as well. The Afcon referees have no skin in the game. It's a case of, yes. Okay, this player was fouled, let me go and check the VAR. Mm-hmm. Was it a foul? Was it not a foul? Yeah. Simple.
I agree with you, and I hope that, just like you said, the final will be free of any form of controversy, because it started well, and your shout out and kudos must go to our dear referees in this Africa Cup of Nations.
All right, speaking of the final, the other team in the final is the Ivory Coast, who defeated DR Congo by a single goal to nil in the other semi-final. Sebastien Allaire with the goal, the cancer survivor, leading the line for Ivory Coast. The striker for Borussia Dortmund in Germany scored the only goal to send Ivory Coast to the final of a tournament where they almost got knocked out. If you think I'm exaggerating, Ivory Coast not only qualified as best loser, they were the worst of the best losers. They finished fourth among the four third place teams that advanced to the round of 16. They've gone on to beat the defending champions, Senegal, on penalty shootouts. They've gone on to beat Mali in a game where they played with a man down for 80 minutes of regulation time and then 30 minutes of extra time. Mm-hmm. They played with a man down for 110 minutes and they ended up winning in the game where Mali lost penalties. And they've also, you know, ended up beating DR Congo. Their run so far has been amazing and nothing short of a fairy tale. Do you think that Nigeria can end this fairy tale?
It's more difficult for Nigeria to face the host nation. Remember, we won them 1-0, and this is the reverse fixture.
So, do you feel like there might be a revenge motivation for
obviously.
I'm not, before you go anywhere, I'm not going to allow you to sit on the fence. So you must, this play that we have today,
I must predict.
So, all your analysis, I'll be here waiting for you.
So, the thing is, I believe that the Super Eagles will take this game. Although I'm skeptical about the fact that whether it will end in the extra time or go to penalties, that one I cannot confirm. But if it goes on a 90-minute spree, I think that the Super Eagles will take the day. And we will celebrate as champions of Africa. This history dates back to 2013, where our first game was a draw, you know, against Burkina Faso. We played the same Burkina Faso, you know, in the final, and we won it. Now, we are playing an Ivory Coast team who have won it twice and we have won it three times. It kind of has that sort of edge or advantage over them. But sometimes in football, all of these things does not matter. It is what you do for the entire 90 minutes.
All right, I hope John is right for the first time being emphatic and not sitting on the fence or not choosing a side that he has chosen to pitch his tent with the green, white, green, the superheroes of Nigeria. As for me, I don't really have a picture for you today. I just hope and pray that Super Eagles win as a Nigerian, and you know, we deserve this. Our fourth Afcon trophy ever, it will be our first in 10 years. We absolutely deserve this. Mm-hmm. But again, I'm afraid of Ivory Coast's fairy tale run. It's looking like this might be their story, and we'll just be part of their story.
Interesting one.
So let's see how that goes. Sunday, 9 p.m. at the Stade Alassane Ouattara Stadium in Abidjan, the stadium that witnessed the opening ceremony and the opening game between Ivory Coast and Guinea-Bissau will host the final between Ivory Coast and the Super Eagles of Nigeria. We will be watching here from Lagos, Nigeria, while our two best guys, Solomon Edivri and Kehinde Idris, will be watching live from the stadium, from pitch side, bringing you the action as it ought. Access that only Prime Sports can give you into the dressing room, press conference, players. You'll be seeing everything. You'll be seeing everything and you'll continue to see everything. And when we win the trophy, the trophy will be right here in the studio. That's our package for today, Prime Sports. It's been a fun ride, John, yesterday. Thank you for coming.
Amazing. Thank you for having me.
All right. Now, the next time you see us, we will either be gold medalist or silver medalist. But anyhow, medalist. See you next time.